We have a 3D diagram here, and the first question, 7.1, is saying show that x axis here is equals to 5 divided by 2 cos theta, right? Let's look at triangle ADC, right, where x lies. On triangle ADC, the only thing we know is that this angle here is 90, and then this angle here is 2 theta, and then we have x there. We don't have any other information. But then if you look at triangle ADB, right, we have theta here, and then we have 5, right, a value here, and then here we have 90. So what you want to do in this kind of questions, you want to start with the triangle that has the most information and move towards to the triangle you're interested in. Clearly, triangle ADB has the most information compared to triangle ADC. So let's start from triangle ABD and move towards triangle ADC. How do we possibly do that? Triangle ABD and triangle ADC, they share line AD. So let's find line AD using triangle ABD, and then from line AD, we then find a way to find the x. So here on triangle ABD, what we can see that sine of theta is equals to opposite divided by hypotenuse, right? So we're going to have sine of theta being equals to opposite is AD, and then the hypotenuse is 5, right? So if we cross multiply, we get AD is equals to 5 sine of theta. So now let's find a way to use AD to find x. If we had the length of DC, then we would just use Pythagoras, right? Because we have an angle of 90 here. But then unfortunately we don't have, so we're gonna use trig ratios. So we can say sine of 2 theta in triangle ADC, right, will be equals to opposite divided by hypotenuse. What is the opposite here? The opposite is AD divided by the hypotenuse, which is x. So again, if we cross multiply, we get AD is equals to x multiplied by sine 2 theta. So now we have two equations for AD. If we equate these two equations, we're going to be able to find x. So we can say now 5 sine of theta is equals to x sine of 2 theta. So we divide both sides by sine of 2 theta, right? We're gonna get x is equals to 5 sine of theta divided by sine 2 theta. This is not exactly what we're looking for, but then if we use the trig identity, sine of 2 theta is equals to sine theta multiplied by cos theta, then we can possibly get there. So now we're gonna get x is equals to 5 of sine theta divided by 2 sine theta and cos of theta. So sine theta and sine theta cancel out, and we are only left with x is equals to 5 divided by 2 cos of theta. And that's how you do 7.1. And then 7.2 says calculate the length of BC if it is given that angle BAC is 112 degrees and theta is equals to 30 degrees. So let's look at BAC, right? So we have an angle here, BAC, which is said to be 112 degrees. So on triangle ABC, we have angle BAC, we have the length of AC, right, which is x, and we just calculated it. And then we have AB, which is 5. We know from definition that the cosine law says that A squared is equals to B squared plus C squared minus 2BC cos of A, right? So A is the side you're interested in. B and C are the other two sides of the triangle, and A is the angle which is opposite to the side you're looking for. So if we're looking for BC, A here will be 112 degrees, right? So let's apply the same idea. So we can say that BC squared, right, will be equals to AB squared, will be equals to AB squared plus AC squared minus 2 multiplied by AB multiplied by AC cos of BAC. So this will be equals to, what is AB? AB is 5, right? So we have 5 squared plus AC squared. AC is X, right? And we know what X is equals to. So here we're gonna have 5 divided by 2 cos of theta. But we are given theta, it is said to be 30 degrees. So we can substitute 30 degrees here. And then minus 2AB, we're saying that AB is 5. And then AC is 5 divided by 2 cos of 30 degrees. And then cos of BAC, which is 112 degrees, right? This is BC squared. And then you will find that BC squared is equals to 44.147. So, and then if you take square roots on both sides, you get BC is equals to 6.64 units.